kind of gave me more ideas, and then I was stripping, and then I was happy with it once I did that. So you can get mad at your work occasionally.
On the one over next to it.
As the same.
Were you mad at that one too?
That one I started first, the square. This is 36 square, that's 24 by 36. And I thought, well, that worked. I'm going to.
Without being mad.
Yes. Okay. Yes. This one here was another one that I got very discouraged because I was working on this and Terry had given me a date of December 23rd. And I'm thinking, oh my God, I've got to get this done, that done. And they were all finishing touches. And I wasn't sure about this one. So I added some. Let me backtrack a minute. When I'm not sure about something, I go into my visual toolbox. And that can be using crayons, using collage, using stencils, and or mark making. I had done no mark making on here. But I did a, and you maybe can't see it from back there, but there is a stencil here, slightly raised, and a slightly raised stencil here. And when I say slightly raised, I will mix my paint with light joint compound. And I mix it up so it's got some thickness to it. I'll put my stencil on, and then I will put it over with a spatula, and then pull it off. So that's how I get a raised stencil. So that I was pleased with. And then I had discovered toilet paper rolls. And now my students bring me all their toilet paper rolls that they're needing. And I realized they make great little stampers. So this is all toilet paper rolls. And one of my students, and that's why I tell them, I learned so much from them. One of them brought four or five in, and she had put a rubber band around them. And she stamped these wonderful oval shapes that look like rocks. So anyway, this started to grow, and then I went up with my marks. And this here was mark making, but this was done with a squeeze bottle with a very tiny tip. Mm-hmm.